But when Cicero Silva of UNIFESP, the Federal University of Sao Paulo, and I, Brett Stahlbaum of the University of California, San Diego, first founded the Walking Tools Laboratory, we also had in mind another art trajectory. We're both really very engaged in our teaching, and also tremendously enjoying giving workshops on locative media for various interested groups. So we found it really, really easy to find inspiration in the work of other creators of software that were intended to be used both by creative people and also to be used in classroom environments. So we were thinking very, very much of software like MaxMSP and PD that were produced by Miller Puckett, or of the generative design-inspired platform Processing by Casey Reese and Ben Fry, or APIs like Open Frameworks by Zachary Lieberman. In other words, we're really interested in these working artists who also create various software tools for other working artists to use in their own work. It occurred to us that locative media needed APIs and tools that were appropriately accessible to students and artists at various levels of experience and technical ability, such that it was possible to assign rich, exciting, and yet appropriately time-constrained projects to the students in our own classes. And slowly, since 2005, in our own classes, in workshops in New Zealand and Germany and Brazil, and most recently in Mexico City and Natal, Brazil, we've been working toward a platform that allows students to, with relative ease, assemble various kinds of media, images, audio, and video with the help of a web application, and to be able to associate these media with latitude and longitude coordinates. After an author uses our web interface and releases a HyperGeo project using our website, the project becomes searchable in the HyperGeo mobile phone application, such that people can follow in the author's feet and trigger the media that the author left in physical space, in the landscape, and experience that media at specific geographic locations. And the outline of how to go about doing that technically is what I'm going to talk about next.